Students, we continue with the word problems of simultaneous equation. We go on to the 8th sum. See, these are all based on pure simple logic. So here you are given that the ratios of A's and B's income is 3 upon 4. Now please understand why you write a common multiple. We cannot say A got 3 rupees and B got 4 rupees. That won't be their income. It would be a multiple of that. Means it could be, the multiple may be 10,000, it may be 50,000. You have to find that. So whenever you have a ratio, don't say A got 3 rupees and B got 4 rupees. You will have to say A's income is 3x and B's income is 4x. Both will have a common multiple, that is why that multiple got cut and the ratio became 3 by 4. So you can't write 3x and 4y, that is wrong. If it's not a common multiple x, then in that case you won't get the ratio as 3 by 4 because the common multiple will not get cut in the numerator and denominator. So now A's income is 3x and B's income is 4x. So now if you take the ratio of the expense, that is also given, that is 5 by 7. Now it's not necessary, it has to be the same multiple. It's a different thing. It's the expense ratio. So let's, but again, this has to be a common multiple and here we will not take x because x we have already took for income ratio. Now we will take it as y. So A's expense is 5y and B's expense is 7y. So ratio of A's and B's expense, when you substitute 5y and 7y, y would have got cancelled. So we got A's income 3x, A's expense 5y, B's income 4x, B's expense 7y. So now based on this, what is saving? Income minus expense is saving. So income minus expense is saving. That is the basic logic that is used in this sum. And that is common sense. How much you earn minus how much you spend is what you save. So for A, from 1 and 3 we get 3x, that is A's income, minus A's expense is 5y, that is equal to 2500. It's given that both of them saved rupees 2500. Same way, for B, from equation 2 and 4, we can say B's income minus B's expense, 4x minus 7y, is 2500. So therefore, now you have two simultaneous equations, 5 and 6. So we generally use method of eliminating the coefficients. So I am making the x coefficient 12 here by multiplying this equation by 4. So equation 5 by 4 gives you 12x minus 20y is 10,000. Now again here in the 6th equation I am making this 12 by multiplying this entire equation by 3. So you will get 12x minus 21y is 7,500. So from these two equations, now I do a minus. This is equation 7 minus equation 8. So all the sign will change. So this becomes 0, this will become 1y, and this will become 2500, which means y is 2500. So I substitute in, let's say, equation 5 to find, I substitute y is 2500, so I get x. X is 5000. 15,000 upon 3, that is 5,000. So A's income is, you are asked both's income. So A's income is 3x, which is 3 times 5,000, 15,000, and B's income is 4x, that is 4 times 5,000, that is 20,000. So you are only asked both's income, but of course, without writing the ratio of expense and all that, and making the two simultaneous equations and solving them, you couldn't find x. So now you have got A's income is 15,000 and B's income is 20,000. Mark this as an important sum. See, generally something like this, which is very common sense based questions, are asked in your boards in February. Even the schools do not ask very tough questions. They ask basic questions which have got something to do with daily life. In these word problems, it is very important to read the question very carefully. So now in the 9th sum, it is given that when the greater of two numbers, so there are two numbers and one number is greater than the other. So we will write the two numbers be x and y, and x is greater than y. So x is the greater number and y is the smaller number. So now it is given, after that the condition, when the greater of the two numbers increased by 1, so x plus 1, greater of the two numbers is x, and that increased by 1 is x plus 1, divides the sum of the numbers. X plus 1 is dividing x plus y. Sum of the numbers is x plus y. And x plus y is the greater of the two numbers increased by 1. See, please read the question carefully. It is given, the greater of the two numbers increased by 1 divides the sum of the two numbers. So x by 1 is the denominator, because it is dividing x plus y. So when you cross multiply, you will get the first equation. Then it is given, the result is 3 by 2. So this result is 3 by 2. So cross multiply, you get the first equation. After that, it is given when the difference of these numbers, so x minus y, the difference of the number means greater number minus smaller number, is divided by, now it is not given divides, it is given is divided by the smaller number. So the difference of the two numbers, x minus y upon y, that is the smaller number, is equal to half. The result is half. So when you cross multiply, you get the second equation. So that is 2x minus 3y is 0. So now when you solve equation 1 and 2 by eliminating the coefficients, so simple way is this entire equation, multiply it by 2 so that it becomes minus 2x and this is plus 2x. And directly add the two equations, equation 3 plus equation 2. So you will get y is equal to 6, that is 1. And once you get y is equal to 6 and substitute y is equal to 6 in any of these equations, then you will get x is equal to 9. So the two numbers are 9 and 6. So you are asked, what are the two numbers? The two numbers x and y are 9 and 6. We go on to the tensor. Yeah. Now in this question, you are given, like these questions are important because you are given the equation that 18 pens and 32 pencils cost rupees 642. And then you are given also that 32 pens and 18 pencils will cost 906. So a standard type of equation. So first of all, we have to take that, let the cost of each pen be rupees x and let the cost of each pencil be rupees y. So 18 pens and 32 pencils is 642. So 18 into cost of each pen is rupees x, and plus 32 into cost of each pencil is y. So 18x plus 32y is 642. Now the other way around, that is 32 pens, 32x, and 18 pencils, so 18y, cost 908. So now see, we had solved in the simultaneous equation without word problems also sums in which the coefficients interchange. So what did we do? We first added the two equations and got another equation. So we are getting 50x plus 50y is 1550. So that equation you divide it by 50, it is totally divisible by 50. So you will get x plus y is 31. And the second thing what you do with this equation 1 and 2, you do equation 1 minus equation 2. So you will get minus 14x plus 14y is equal to minus 266. So once you've got that, you will divide this equation by 14. Why not minus 14? Because I am retaining the minus sign here, because this was plus x. So I am dividing it by 14. So I will get minus x plus y is equal to minus 19. So from that, I am now solving. This is called the fourth equation, and I am going to solve it with the third equation. So directly I can add, because already the coefficients are x and minus x. So I add it. So this becomes 0, 2y is equal to 12, so y is equal to 6. So once I get y, I can substitute it in a simple equation like equation 3 and get x is equal to 25. So x is what? I don't leave this answer as x and y. I have to find what is the cost of each pen. Cost of each pen is x, that is rupees 25, and cost of each pencil is y, that is rupees 6. So copy this down, we go on to the next sum. Now consider the 11th sum. Each one A and B has some money, we don't know how much. So let's say A had rupees X and B had rupees Y. So we are taking two variables X and Y. A had rupees X and B had rupees Y. Now after this, some cases are given, like what conditions are given. A is giving rupees 50 to B. So A will have X minus 50 and B will have Y plus 50. Naturally, he gave 50 rupees, so his 50 rupees decreased. And he gave it to B, so B's 50 rupees increased. So now it is given that B will have twice the money as much as what was there with left with A. So B is equal to 2 times A. So now B, after getting that 50 rupees, will have 2 times what A had. So when you solve this equation, you will get 2x minus y is 150. Now there is a second condition also given. It is given that if B gives 20 rupees to A, so y minus 20, B will have rupees y minus 20, and A will have x plus 20, because B has now removed 20 rupees and given, and A has accepted that 20 rupees. Then A will have 3 times as much as money is there with B. So A's money, x plus 20, will be 3 times y minus 20. So when you solve that, you get the second equation, x minus 3y is equal to minus 80. So now this equation has 2x, that equation has x. So I will multiply this equation throughout by 2 to make the coefficient 2x. So 2x minus 6y is minus 160. That is equation 3, and I have rewritten this same equation 1 there. So now I have to do equation 3 minus equation 1. So therefore this becomes 0, this is minus 5y, and this is now minus 310. So from that I get y is 62. So B had originally rupees 62. And when you solve this, y is equal to 62, you can substitute in this equation, you will get x is rupees 106. So therefore, A has x, that is rupees 106. So A has 106 rupees and B has 62 rupees. So that's how you will solve this sum. Now please remember one thing. In your exams, generally, these sort of general sums, that is the first 11 sums of classwork, and similarly the general sums of homework, that is the first 11 sums of homework, that is what is asked. Other than that, generally they limit themselves to 2-digit number and age problems. So they don't ask anything else. They don't ask speed time and distance speed time. Those sums are generally not asked in the boards. Why I have included it in the book is just because there are some textbooks. In ICSE there is no standard textbook. But there are some textbooks which has speed and time and distance sums, so I have included it. The syllabus book doesn't say whether it is there or not. So generally in school exams, they limit themselves to the first 11 general sums, age related sums, age, father's age, son's age, all that. And then 2-digit number, those sums. So first we will complete 2-digit number sums and then 8 sums after this. And then we will see the distance, speed, time sums later. Because that is generally not asked in school exams, it's not there in concise also. Work sums are there, so work sums also we will do, work related. A and B is doing some work in so many days, those sums. But distance, speed, time sums are there in standard 10 also. So I'll be taking that up at the end of the chapter. So we go on to now 2-digit number sums. That is, we will start with question 12. Now for sums based on two-digit numbers. Now you will have in a two-digit number tens place and units place. For example, let's say the number is 69. So how do you write 69? It is 6 into 10 and units place is 9, so 9 into 1 and add the 2. 60 plus 9 is 69. So that's the same logic that you will use when you write tens place is x and units place is y. So the number will be 10x plus y. Just like you wrote 6 into 10 plus 1 into 9 and added the 2. So 69. So that is how you represent two digit number 10x plus y, where x is the tens place and y is the units place. So now first of all, in your next sum, that is question number 12, it is given that the sum of the digits of a two-digit number is 5. So let's first take tens place is x and units place is y. So the sum of the digits means x plus y is equal to 5. After that, it is given the digit obtained by increasing the digit in the tens place by unity. So the digit obtained by increasing the digit in the tens place by unity, that is x plus 1. The digit in the tens place is x. Increasing it by unity means by 1. So x plus 1. That digit will be 1/8 of the number. What is the number? The number is 10x plus y. So the number, because the tens place was x and units place is y, number is 10x plus y. So, by doing that, you have got the number obtained by increasing the digit in the tens place by unity is 1/8 of the number. This is what is given in the question. So, x plus 1 is 1/8 of the number was 10x plus y. So, now when you cross multiply and solve, you will get the second equation, that is minus 2x minus y is equal to minus 8. So that is the next equation that you got. You already have the first equation, x plus y is 5. So those two equations when you add, because the coefficients are same and already the sign is plus minus different. So when you add 3 plus 1, you will get minus x plus 0 is equal to minus 3. So x is equal to 3. So, because x is equal to 3, you can substitute, you will get y equal to 2. So, from 1 and 2, you are asked what is the original number. The original number is 10x plus y, that is 10 times 3 plus y is 2. So, 30 plus 2, that is 32. So, that's how you solve a sum typically. Just understand the method first. Take tens place as x, unit place as y, so the original number is 10x plus y. So then the condition given is sum of the two digits is 5, so x plus y is 5. The digit obtained by increasing the tens place by unity is tens place was x, unity means 1, so x plus 1. So that the digit obtained by increasing the units place, tens place by unity is 1/8 of the original number is 10x plus y. So you get your second equation, then it is solving the two sums simultaneously. These two-digit number sums, classwork, homework are all important. So you can expect either two-digit number or AH ka one sum at least in your exam. Either an AH sum will come or a two-digit number will come or work problem will come. Mostly it is two-digit number or AH sum. We go on to the next sum, that is question 13. So again, whenever you have a two-digit number sum, first thing you write, the digit in the tens place is x and the digit in the units place is y. So the original number is 10x plus y. These three lines are standard. After that, you have to see the given conditions. It is given that the original number is 7 times the sum of the digits. That is what is given in the question. The two-digit number is 7 times the sum of the digits. So you have 10x plus y, the two-digit number, is 7 times x plus y. So when you substitute and solve, you get the first equation, that is 3x minus 6y equal to 0. That is the first equation. Then you have got the number formed by reversing the digits is 10y plus x. You are given that the number formed by reversing the digits is 18 less than the original number. So when the reverse digits means now tens place is y and units place is x. You have just reversed it. So the number will be 10y plus x. The number will become ulta. The tens place has now become the units place, that is x has gone and got multiplied with 1, and y is now the tens place, that's the number obtained by reversing the digits. So your 69 will become 96 that way. First you have done 6 into 10 and 1 into 9, so you got 69. Now you are doing 9 into 10 and 1 into 6, so you get 96. So 10y plus x is the number obtained by reversing the digits. This number is 18 less than the original number, so if you add 18 to this number, after reversing the digits, if you add 18, you will get the original number, that is 10x plus y. So 10y plus x plus 18 is 10x plus y. So once you solve this, you get the second equation. So from that, you have minus 9x plus 9y is minus 18. I purposely did not divide it by minus 9. Because this equation, I find it simpler. I will multiply this by 3, the entire equation, so that this also will become 9x. So I got 9x minus 18y equal to 0. That is equation 3. Now the coefficients of x in the second and third equation are same. So I add the two equations, I will get minus 9y is minus 18, or y is 2. So once I have found y, I can substitute in this equation and I found x is 4. So they have asked you what is the original number. Original number was 10x plus y. So 10 times 4 plus 2, that is 42. That's the original number. So the next question, that is the 14th question. Again, it is 2-digit number sum, so the first 3 steps is the same. Let the digit in the tens place be x, and let digit in unit place be y. Therefore, the original number is 10x plus y. So now you are even given something related with number obtained by interchanging digits. So therefore, 10y plus x is the number obtained by interchanging digits. After that, you are given 4 times a certain 2-digit number. So the original number into 4. 4 times 10x plus y is equal to, is 7 times the number obtained by interchanging the digit. So 7 times 10y plus x. That gives you the first expression, that is 33x minus 66y is 0. So from there you will get x minus 2y is 0. After that you have the next, that is, if the difference between the digit is 4, so obviously here we are assuming one thing, that x is greater than y, so you are writing x minus y is 4, that's the second equation. Then you can simply solve the two equations. You have x already same, but you are going to minus, so the sign of each term will change, plus minus becomes plus becomes minus, so you will get, this becomes y is equal to 4. So if y is equal to 4, substituted in equation 1, you will get x is 8. So the original number is 10x plus y. So 10 times 8 plus y, that is 84. So the original number will become 84. So that completes the 2-digit number classwork sums. We will go on to the age-related sums now. So we have to do some sums based on age. So this is another type of sum which is very important, because as I told you, the first 11 sums, which are general sums based on common logic, then the 2-digit number sums and age related sums are very important. So age related few sums we will do now, and few sums we will do on Zoom. So now in the first question of related to age in classwork, you have got problems based on age on page 31, the 15th question. It gives you that 6 years hence means from today, again, 6 years after today, a man's age will be 3 times his son's age. So, man, the father will be 3 times his son's age. And 3 years ago, 3 years ago means 3 years back, the father was 9 times as old as his son. So you are asked to find their present ages, a typical sum. Then nothing complicated will come, very simple sums like this will come. So first thing is, we take son's present ages X years and father's present ages Y years. So X and Y are both taken. Son's present age X and father's present age Y. Now 6 years hence means after today. 6 years. Son would be X plus 6 and father would be Y plus 6. Father today is Y, so his age also will increase by 6, and son today is X, so his age also will increase by 6. So X plus 6 and Y plus 6. But father is 3 times the son's age. It is given that 6 years hence, the father will be 3 times the son's age. So father's age 6 years hence, Y plus 6, is equal to 3 times son's age 6 years hence. When they are talking about 6 years hence, every relation is with respect to 6 years hence for both father and son. So that when you frame it, you get the first expression, Y is equal to 3x plus 12. I write that as equation number 1. They have given a second condition in the question, that is 3 years ago. Now 3 years ago the son's age was X minus 3 and father's age was Y minus 3. So but father is 9 times son's age. 3 years ago the father is not 3 times, that is 6 years hence, but 3 years ago the father was 9 times the son's age, that's also clearly given. So father 3 years ago Y minus 3 is 9 times son age 3 years ago X minus 3. So Y minus 3 is 9X minus 27. So Y is 9X minus 24. So this is what you get for Y. So you have equation 1 and you have equation 2. So from 1 and 2 you have 3X plus 12 equal to 9x minus 24. So from that, when you rewrite it in terms of x, you will get everything in terms of x. So you have used the substitution method. This is also y, that is also y. So you can say that 3x plus 12, this is y, is equal to that y, that is 9x minus 24. So you have not used elimination method, but here you have used substitution method, which is simple. So directly you have gotten rid of y and you have written everything in terms of x. See, 3x plus 12 is y, 9x minus 24 is y. So since both of them are y, so you get 6x is 36, or x is equal to 6. So substituting x is equal to 6 in equation 1, you will get the value of y. Either in 1 or in 2 you can substitute. So when you do that, you get y is equal to 3 into 6 plus 12, so 30 years. So this is the son's present age, x. See, when they ask you their ages, that means they are asking you the present ages. Unless it is asked that what was his age, what will be his age 5 years hence or something, they always ask you the present ages. So present age of son is x, which is 6 years. And father's present age is Y, which is 30 years. So that is how you do a age related sum. Now I will explain you a couple of sums where it is work related. See, the idea is that even maybe 4 months after today, when you may be writing a prelim paper, you may have some doubts in this. You can always refer this and most of your doubts will be solved. Of course, some of the sums we are even doing it live on Zoom, so there also you can ask it out. So both the things are happening simultaneously. Now these work related sums, these sort of sums you have to understand the concept of how to solve it. Once you have understood it, it is easy. But you may have to look at this sum's explanation maybe 2-3 times. So that you really understand it, and when you do similar sums and apply it a couple of times, that is when it will be ingrained in your head so that you don't forget it. So now in this sum, page 32, question 22, which is a classwork sum, it is given that 3 men and 4 boys can do a piece of work in 14 days. So 3 men and 4 boys are able to do the work in 14 days. While 4 men and 6 boys does it in 10 days. 4 men and 6 boys. They have changed the number of men and boys, and so they can do it in 10 days. From that it is asked, how long will it take one boy to finish the work? The most common mistake some students make is that they just write 3x plus 4y is equal to 14 and 4x plus 6y is equal to 10, and they try to solve it, and sometimes by fluke they come at the correct answer also they get, so they think it is right, but there is no logic to that. It is not like the sum in which you had this many number of pens plus this many number of pencils cost this much. In there you can write each pen cost X, and there is a logic to that. Here that logic doesn't work. You can't say that 3x plus 4y is equal to 14. There is no logic in that. It is not that the boys take X days, so 3 boys will take more days. There is no logic in that. So the sum has to be logically explained. Now here it is, first thing what you have to take is, you are asked how many days the boy will take, one boy will take to do the work. So we have, let's say the man takes, one man take X days. So in one day, how much of that work will be done? He will do 1 upon X of that work. For example, if one man takes 50 days to do the work, in one day he will do 1 by 50 of the total work, obviously. So if it is X days, it will be 1 by X of the total work. So this has logic, that if one person takes 15 days to do the work, in one day he will do 1/15 of the work. So if he took X days, he will do it to do 1x of the total work. Similarly, we are taking, let one boy, let him take Y days. We are assuming few things, that every day they are working equally. Hence it is not that everything is kept for the last day. And then last day, bahut mehnat kiya aur kaam khatam kiya. It is not that. We are assuming that they are doing the work consistently. And we are also assuming that all the men and all the boys are doing the same amount of work. That means all the men are doing 1x of the work in one day, and all the boys are doing 1y of the work in one day. Boys and men are not doing the same. Maybe they are younger, so they may be doing less work, and these men are doing more work. Could be that way. But this makes sense. If one boy takes y days, then in one day he will do 1 by y of the total work. So if one boy takes 20 days, in one day he will do 1 by 20th of the work. So first thing is to make it in terms of one day. So then you are given, then the question says, 3 men and 4 boys. So how much will 3 men do in one day? How much work will 3 men do in one day? One man was doing 1x of the work. So 3 men will do 3 times 1x of the work. This was what one man was doing. So 3 men will do 3 into 1 by x, so 3 by x. Now 4 men's work in one day. 4 men's work in one day. It should be 4 boys' work in one day. Because second you have considered the boys. So you are given 4 boys' work in one day will be y by 4. One boy's was 1 by 4. So 4 boys will do 4 times that, so 4 by y. So this will be multiplied by 4, so you get 4 by y. After that, as per the condition, it is given that 3 men and 4 boys take 14 days. 3 men and 4 boys, they are taking 14 days to do the work. So in one day, how much will 3 men and 4 boys take? 1 by 14. They will do 1 by 14 of the total work. So now you have got 3 equations here. 3 men's work in one day, plus 4 boys' work in one day, is equal to how much work they did together in one day. So here, the equation that you write, the important part, which is the first equation, is three men's work in one day plus four boys' work in one day is equal to 1 by 14 of the total work in one day. So 3 upon x plus 4 upon y is 1 upon 14. Because 3 men's work in one day was 3 by x, 4 boys' work in one day is 4 by y, and together 3 men's and 4 boys' work in one day is 1 by 14 of the total work. So it is 1 by 14. So this is how you frame the first expression. Second expression, again, since you have already written all that, the second condition is 4 men's work plus 6 boys take 10 days. So they take 10 days, so in one day how much they will do? 1/10. So 4 men's work in one day plus 6 boys work in one day is 1 by 10 of the total work that they do in one day. They do 1/10 of the total work in 4 men and 6 boys. So now men one day is 1 by x, so 4 into 1 by x is 4 by x. And the second case is 6 boys work in one day, so 6 into 1 by y. Boys work in one day is 1 by y, so 6 into 1 by y is equal to what they do together in one day, that is 1/10 of the total work. So this gives you the second expression. This is how you frame the second equation from what is given here. 4 men and 6 boys, they together take 10 days. So 4 men's work in one day plus 6 boys work in one day is 1/10 of the total work that they do. So when you solve equation 2 and 1 simultaneously, again I have told you no problem if x and y is in the denominator. Just equate the coefficient. No need of writing 1 by x is a. I have seen that people forget to resubstitute. If you do that, then you have to resubstitute after getting the value of a, that a is equal to 1 by x, and then find. Many students forget that in the exam in haste. So better to write this equation, you multiply it by 3 so that you get 12 by x. And this equation you multiply it by 4. So that you get 12 by x here also. Then you can eliminate x. So equation 1 into 4 and equation 2 into 3 gives you 12 by x, 12 by x, both the equations minus. So when you do that, you get minus 2y by is equal to, here you will not be able to do it directly, so you will have to write 4 by 14 minus 3 by 10. So minus 2yy, when you cross multiply, it will be 40 minus 42. So minus minus will get cut, 2 will also get cut. So you get y is equal to 140 days. Now this sort of a sum, don't make this error where you write 3x plus 4y is equal to 14. Absolutely no logic in this. And the second equation, some people write 4x plus 6y is equal to 10. And then they try to solve it. This, whether it gives you the correct answer or not, makes no sense. So you can't write it that way. You have to explain it in terms of each person's work, what they do in one day. So everywhere I have written in one day how much the boys do, together how much they do in one day, all that is equated, and then that makes sense with respect to the equation. So this cannot be explained and it doesn't make sense, so don't do this and solve it, even if maybe by chance the final answer is the same. So do one more sum of h. And then the rest of the 8 sums we will do in the Zoom session. Yeah, now here in question number 23 of classwork, it is quite similar and the logic is the same like the 22nd sum. So now it is given that Pooja and Ritu can do a piece of work in 17 and 17 day. So first of all, there are two people, Pooja and Ritu, they are doing some work. Together, they can do it in 17 1/7 total days. In one day, Pooja does 3/4 of the work done by Ritu. So now in one day also, they have given the relation. So first thing you have to understand is that you, let's take Ritu takes X days and Pooja takes Y days total. So in one day, Ritu will do 1/X of the total work and Pooja will do 1/Y of the total work. So that is how it is done by Pooja and Ritu. But Pooja's work in one day is equal to 3/4 of Ritu's work in one day. That is given. That is one of the conditions given. This is already mentioned in the sum, that Pooja's work in one day is equal to 3/4 of Ritu's work in one day. So Pooja, how much she does in one day? 1/Y. 3/4 of Ritu's work in one day is 1/X. So that gives you the first relation. When you cross, you will get X is equal to 3/4 of Y. So that's the first equation. Then X goes there and Y goes there on the numerator. So you can say that X is equal to 3/4 Y. This is the first expression. Then together, Pooja and Ritu is taking 17 1/7 day. So in one day, Ritu, Pooja's work in one day plus Ritu's work in one day is equal to what they do together in one day. Since they took 17 1/7 day, in one day they will do 1/17 by 1/7. For example, if you take 20 days to do a work, then in one day you will do 1/20 of the total work. So Pooja's work in one day plus Ritu's work in one day is equal to work done together in one day. This is work done together in one day. So therefore, Pooja 1/Y and Ritu 1/X is equal to 1/, when you convert that into a fraction, it will become 120/7. So obviously 7 will go on the numerator upon 120. And you can write 1/X plus 1/Y, that doesn't make a difference. So now substituting equation 1, you already know that X is equal to 3/4 Y. So 1/3/4 Y plus 1/Y is 7/120. So from that you will get, when you take this, 4 will go on the numerator, so it will become 4/3y plus 1/y is 7/120. So LCM of this is 3, so 3y is the LCM. So this second term is multiplied by 3, so 4 plus 3/3y is 7/120. So 7, when you write this, 7 into 120 by 7/3 will be y. Only y is shifted there. This is the 7 and this is the 3 here, and 120/7 came this side. So you will get y is equal to 40 days. That means Pooja takes 40 days to do her work and Ritu is taking 3/4 of Pooja, which you have already written. So x is equal to 3/4 of y, so x is equal to 30. So Ritu takes 30 days and Pooja takes 40 days. With this, all the types of sums that come in your exam, as I told you, there is no distance, type and speed, that sort of sums in your concise textbook. So usually in your Bombay Scottish and Gopal Sharma papers, that is not asked. But I will take it up later, after your unit test or in the next class. Right now you focus on this so that you can do your unit test very well. So we will also be doing some sums in Zoom. So this will remain for your reference. These sort of sums, maybe after 4 months also, when you are writing a term exam, maybe the term exams are held in school in October or November, may not be possible before that. So that time also you can refer and see this, which will not be possible if it is only done on Zoom. So both are happening. Copy this. With that, we end today's session.